The house isn't in good condition, but it does have vacant possession and a unique history. All the tenants of 23 Cranley Gardens, Muswell Hill, moved out last February, shortly after police arrested Dennis Nilsen, the homosexual civil servant jailed at the beginning of this month for 6 murders and 2 attempted murders. The man who told police he'd killed a total of 16 men and that he felt no pity for his victims. He even boiled parts of them in his kitchen.
When I realised what had been happening next door, I felt ill. It was horrible. I used to smell the cooking. I didn't know what it was. I do now, and I, you know, after the event.
3 of Nielsen's victims were chopped up here in the front room of his top-floor flat. Police removed human limbs from this room. Now they've fumigated and redecorated the whole flat and replaced all the plumbing. The house's owner, an Indian housewife, wants a quick sale. There's no fixed price. The house is open to offers.
It could be that the property won't sell at all, or it could be that it will fetch an astronomical price.
Houses round here normally do sell quite easily, don't they?
Yes, they do. They do. I understand that the value, if it was not affected by the incident, would be in the region of 60,000 to 70,000.
How are you going to sort out people who want to come and look at the house, people who actually might want to buy it, and others who just want to have a look?
Yes, we haven't actually decided how to deal with this problem. We do anticipate getting a number of time wasters, people that just want to sightsee and come along and have a look. I suppose we'll have to have an open day or something just to let people come and have a look.
There have already been 3 offers for 23 Cranley Gardens, and a film company may rent the house to make a film of Dennis Nielsen's grisly and incredible story. Ros Morris in Muswell Hill for Thames News.